Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I am back with another video. In this video, we are going to install a OpenMRS project. So what is OpenMRS? Basically, OpenMRS is a open source enterprises electronic medical record system platform. It is three-tier application. It is required a web server or app server in front and database in backend. So we are going to use Tomcat has a application server and MySQL has a database server. You can use this project for your DevOps learning path, or you can use this project for a hospital to maintain their record. You can download the OpenMRS project code from the GitHub. I'll provide the GitHub URL for this project in the video description. So I'm cloning this project on my local machine. Cloning has been completed. Now I'm going to compile and package this project by using Eclipse IDE. You can use any IDE with your choice to compile and package this project. Okay. Open the OpenMRS project. Okay, and finish it. Now we require to compile and web app project. It is going to packaging a WAR file for you. Let's go ahead and compile and package. Do a right click and click on run as, then click on Maven build. Goals will be package. Go ahead and apply and run it. So it is going to download all the required dependency and finally packaging a WAR file for you. Build successfully completed. It created two package file. One is WAR file and second is jar file. We are going to use WAR file. Here is our WAR file. Now let's go ahead and install the Tomcat. For the Tomcat, I'm installing Oracle JDK 8.2.x. I am starting a installation process for JDK. Go for selection 1. JDK installation process has been completed. Let's verify a Java version. Java version 1.8.0 has been installed. Now let's go ahead and install Apache Tomcat. So we successfully unzip the Tomcat binaries on the machine. Now let's go ahead and assign the executable permission on bin folder. Now let's verify the Tomcat version. Tomcat 8.5. installed on machine. Now let's go ahead and start Tomcat on this machine. Okay, Tomcat started. Let's verify. Yes, Tomcat is running on machine. Now let's deploy openmrs.war file. We are deploying the openmrs.war file. It is same file we just compiled and packaged into target folder via Eclipse IDE. Let's go ahead and deploy. It's done. let's go ahead and restart Tomcat. Tomcat restarted. Let's verify the application. War file successfully deployed. Now we require to set up the OpenMRS application and we require a MySQL database in backend. So let's go ahead and install the MySQL database. This is my database server. I'm installing MySQL 5.x series. Download the MySQL package. Now let's go ahead and run the RPM. And finally, install MySQL server. Okay, it's done. Let's check the MySQL database status. It is down. Let's start it. Now MySQL database is running. Let's grab the temporary password for MySQL database. This is your temporary password for MySQL root user. Now let's modify the mysql.conf file. Let's add a option. Validate password policy is low. It means that MySQL is not enforcing you to create a complex password. This setting is recommended only for testing environment. Let's go ahead and save it. Restart MySQL to load new changes. Now start configuration of MySQL database. Supply your temporary password and create a new password. Change the password for root, say yes. Do you want to continue with the password provided, say yes. Remove anonymous users, say yes. Disallow root login remotely, say no. Because we require to connect this MySQL database with root user from OpenMRS Tomcat application server, say no. Remove test database or access to it, it's your choice. I'll go with no. Reload privilege table now, say yes. Well done guys. Try to login into MySQL server now. Enter the password. We are inside. In this command, we are granting all the privilege to this user account identified with this password. It means that we are going to connect this MySQL server from Tomcat application server to create OpenMRS database remotely. Let's go ahead and execute it. Reload privileges. Out from MySQL server. Restart MySQL server now. Check the status. It is running. We all set to configure OpenMRS database now. So go back to OpenMRS web application and start to configure it. Go with advanced and change with your MySQL database server or IP address. Mine is 192.168.10.11. Do you currently have OpenMRS database? Say no. So it is going to create a new database with name OpenMRS. Supply password of MySQL root user account. Next, do you need OpenMRS to automatically create the table? Say yes. Do you want also add demo data to your database? Say yes. Okay. Do you currently have database user other than root? Say no and give the MySQL root password. Next, do you want to able to upload modules from the web interface? Say yes. Do you want to update to the database automatically on every application deployment? Say no and next. Give the password of admin user for OpenMRS application. Click on next. Leave blank all the options. Review and confirm all the options and click on next. It has created a database for you. It has created a database user, created OpenMRS tables, added core features of OpenMRS, adding demo data for the OpenMRS project, updating the database. Okay. OpenMRS project has been successfully configured and it is running. Now we require to install a user interface module. So go back to your OpenMRS web server. You require to deploy user interface module in this location. If you are configuring OpenMRS under root account, you can download the user interface. Go ahead and download it. Okay, legacy UI interface has been deployed. Now let's go ahead and restart Tomcat service. Tomcat started. Try to access OpenMRS application now. If you encounter 500 internal server error, then wait couple of seconds and try again. Okay, OpenMRS application successfully started with legacy user interface. Now let's try to login in the application. Use the password which you created during the setup process. I am connected with admin profile. Let's look at the administration. Let's look at the manage location. Let's add a location. I am adding a location for a hospital. Save location. Now create a patient. Create a new patient. Add ID numbers and location is Life Care Hospital. Go ahead and save it. Now suppose that John D patient visit the hospital and so you require to add a entry of his visiting. So click on find or create patient. You can search the patient with the identified number or name. Let's try to search with the name. We got two John in our database. Our John is 1011. Click on it and click on start widget. Select the widget type, outpatient, start date and location, and save it. Similar way, we can make his exit entry like and widget. It's done. So it is a basic walkthrough how you can use OpenMRS application for your DevOps learning path or in a hospital industry. I hope you enjoy this video. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.